on the island of Cuba, initiating the Cuban Missile Crisis. And the countdown to nuclear war had begun. Never had the world come so close to all-out nuclear war. Never had the stakes been so high. In that weekend of the crisis, many people believed that they would never live to see the next weekend. And people rushed to stock up on food and to find bomb shelters to hide from the toxic nuclear gases. In the hours before the new U.S. crisis team met, they decided where and when to invade Cuba to destroy the Soviet nuclear missiles. The Soviet Union finally lived. And Khrushchev announced on Radio Moscow that the Soviet Union was removing their missiles from Cuba. In return, the U.S. agreed to remove their missiles from Turkey and Italy, not to invade Cuba. The world had just stepped aside from annihilating itself. And of course, my country was saved. None of you would be here today if the Cuban Missile Crisis had erupted into nuclear war. The world would be a much more dangerous place if not for men and women of peace and conscience. The activist folk musicians of the early 60s played a humongous role in telling the world the truth and guiding the world from conflict to peace. The Nobel Committee was right in awarding Bob Dylan the Nobel Prize, but they were wrong in waiting 53 years to do it. I have to leave you now, and I place you in the safe hands of your Toastmaster, Joe. Well, hello, everyone. Madam President, guests, ladies and gentlemen. There are three songs in Dylan's second album, which were instrumental in earning him his Nobel Prize. Fidel Castro has already spoken about the hard rain and its connection to the Cuban Missile Crisis. Dylan's second song, Masters of War, was about government hunger for war and the lies and deception to the people. And you know, this is still taking place today, even as I speak. Dylan's third song is possibly his best known. Personally for me, Bob Dylan has been a giant whose shoulders I've stood on to teach my two daughters how to think, creativity, language, conscience. And in order to channel Dylan's genius to my kids, I myself have had to become a student of Dylan. And one huge lesson I've taken away from this great man is that sometimes it is much more important to ask the right questions than it is to give the correct answers. And this is beautifully illustrated in his third song, which I will now attempt to play and sing. And for those of you who know this song, please sing along with me. I don't have a strong singing voice. Let's all sing together.